On the Clock users, thank you for joining us today. Today we're just going to go over how to use the mobile app as an admin and a manager of On the Clock. So if you're already a user and you've been invited, go ahead and enter in your email address and your password and click log in. If you're brand new and just getting started, click new company to create your company account and enter in your credentials so that you can log in. So we're going to go ahead and log in. And once you log into the app, you're going to be on a dashboard view. Everything on the dashboard is interactive. Up at the top left, you're going to see your initials as well as an indicator here. This says A for administrator. If you're a manager, you're going to see an M. If you click this, it's going to bring out a flyout menu. And inside here, you're just going to see the company name as well as your role and then a PIN number. So admins and managers are going to have a PIN. Go ahead and use this PIN number to get support. This will help us locate your account quicker. One of the first things to do as an administrator is to go ahead and click your account settings. This is going to get us started with setting up our pay period. So inside this screen, you're going to have your time zone selection as well as putting in your pay period type, weekly, anywhere to monthly. And then setting your pay period start date and time rounding options if you have any. So we have 0, 6, and 15. That's going to depend on your policy. 0 is going to be real time, and then of course we'll round at those other increments if you choose them. One thing to note is if you are selecting semi-monthly, you will have to put in your first day of the first pay period as well as the second day, and then also specify your work start day of the work week, just so that we can group together 7 consecutive days for accurate overtime calculations. And the same is true for your monthly pay period types. Once you're satisfied with your account settings here, you're going to go ahead and hit save. One thing to note, if you are a manager, in your flyout menu, you will not have an account settings button and you won't be able to manage those settings. So the next thing that you're going to notice in your flyout menu is a launch in browser. Some of you may not have known that this was here, but we do have the option to launch into the mobile web browser inside the app. You just go ahead and click this and this will bring up our full site. Our full site will have more options as far as what you can do with employee setup as well as more account setting options as well. Inside of here, you'll also have access to changing password and logging out if you log out. And then right below that is our help. So if you click this, you can actually submit an email straight from the app for more support. And if you are inside of the flyout menu, to get it to go away, simply swipe it over to the left. So moving back to this dashboard view, over to our top right corner, we have a gray chat bubble. This is just where we can start conversation threads. A conversation can be with anybody, so it can be with an additional admin, it can be with a manager or your employees, and you would just enter in a subject and then select who this is going to go to. So we call this our participant, hit create, and you'll be brought to a screen to type your message. You can send that off with this little icon here. And your employees or your managers or anyone using the app will get a push notification or they'll get a badge notification on the website. So moving back into our dashboard, right when you land on this screen, you're going to see some data points as far as how many total hours were worked for a pay period, and you could also toggle to the day, so you could see it in a day view or by pay period. This is interactive, so you can actually get to your time card summary by clicking time card here, and you're going to see all of your employees' time cards here. And if you click details over here, this is just going to give us a nice detailed report of our employees. So this is nice to just look over if you're going to be approving time or anything like that. And if you needed more details inside of the day to see what was going on, you click this little icon here. And this just gives us more details inside of here. So up at the top of this specific time card entry, we have an add punch and an add hours. If you're an administrator, you'll always have the capability to edit with these options. If you're a manager, you might not, depending on what your permission level is. So scrolling down the time card entry, we have the name and the date of the entry, as well as the punch log, which is just going to present any in and out times. If I wanted to get more details about this punch, I can click here. And then I'm brought into an edit punch hours. So actually right in this screen, we could make adjustments. And if we needed to add an attachment for the employee, we could do that here and click save. So on your time card summary page, you'll notice a couple options over here in the right corner. The plus is to add time. So if I click on this plus icon, I can actually add an entry. And this is from scratch, so I can just select the employee that I would like to add an entry for. And then I can decide how I would like to add that entry. So add punch is going to be me adding in times or out times for the employee. Or if I'm just adding in straight hours, I can click add hours. And just simply type the number of hours worked, possibly add an attachment, maybe a note, and then save this entry. And that's complete. So if you needed to backlog and add days because you're just starting midweek, but yesterday wasn't accounted for, you could do that by hitting the plus icon at the very top of your time card summary. So moving back into our dashboard, if you scroll down, you're going to see a who's in. This is also interactive, but right now it is showcasing that 3 employees are in and 19 are out. If you want more details as to who those employees are, you can click here and it's going to bring you into that screen that you're used to. And you'll notice that the icon highlights below. So what screen we're in actually highlights below if it's on the nav on the bottom. So right here we can see our statuses. We can see that 3 of our employees are IPD, which just means in prior day, so they must have forgotten to clock out. But we could also clock somebody in from here by clicking that little over arrow. And I can go ahead and adjust this time. This is a good day of fix. So I can punch somebody in so that they're ready to continue on and punch out and back in for their lunch and then punch out for the rest of the day. So moving back into the dashboard again, underneath our who's in, we do have a quick add widget. So this is actually going to allow us to add employees, add hours, create jobs, and more. So if you click this plus icon, you're going to get a quick add screen and you can choose what it is you'd like to add. So we can add additional admins, we can add managers from here, departments, jobs. And if I click employee, it's going to bring me into the form to fill out so I can specify a number, a first name, a last name, email address or username, and I could turn on job selections and departments if I have entered those, and that would just allow the employee to make the selection for that as they clock in and out. Or I could assign a department here to the employee. And then you'll want to set your employee's time zone, and then optionally you could assign a manager to the employee. Once you're satisfied with the information here, you'll just go ahead and hit save. So if you are brand new to On the Clock and you're wondering what to do first, scroll down and click the add button and go ahead and add some employees and also some managers and maybe some additional admins. Next, you're going to see paid time off. Paid time off setup is going to happen at the website level. So if you are planning to set up paid time off tracking for your employees, you're going to want to go ahead and click your initials, get to that flyout menu and launch into browser. But if you already have it set up, you will notice that you can see anything that's pending, as well as who's off today and who's off in the next 7 days. This is interactive, so you can click and you'll see all the pending requests that you could click into and approve. And we would just come down and we could approve or deny this. And depending on how your employees set up, if they have an email address listed, we'll send an email with the status. And if they have a phone number on file, we'll SMS text that. And if I were to click off today, it's going to nav me over to PTO requests for that day. And then in the next 7 days, it would bring me over to the PTO requests that were approved within that time period. And I would just hit apply to change this. And then down below, we have punch map. So if you were looking to track GPS on your employees, you will want to set up your mobile rule inside of the web browser. So again, you're going to want to click the flyout menu, click launch into browser, and select your employee's profile and get them set up that way. So we'll just click view map. So if you are already set up for GPS tracking, we'll notice that pins are dropping, and if you click on the pin, it is going to give us some details about that punch. So we can see an in and an out, and you can filter up here in the right. So we could actually filter this by all employees or by a select employee, and then we could also filter by a date that we would like to view, and then we would just hit apply. So moving right down on this screen, we can see at the bottom there are some navigation controls that we can just click as well. So time cards is going to bring us right into the time card summary. PTO is going to bring us into that interactive PTO screen with requests, pending, approved, denied options, as well as the selection of an employee that we would like to view. The plus symbol in the corner is just where we could add in a PTO request for an employee. You'll want to make your employee selection first. And here we can actually fill out at that admin manager level a PTO request for somebody. So if somebody missed today, I could put in 8 hours, request the PTO, approve it, and be on our way. And then right down below, we do have the Who's In, which will just bring us right where the dashboard brought us, but right into the Who's In screen, where we could see who's currently in or out and clock them in and out. Then we have our More. So underneath More, we're gonna get all of those same controls that we have on the dashboard, just laid out in a different format. But one thing to note is inside of here, we're gonna have a couple options that appear. You're gonna have a group punch mode. This is launched inside of the web browser as well. So if you turn group punching on inside the website, you'll get this icon here where you can actually confirm and put a device into group punch at the admin level. And if you turned on scheduling inside of the web browser as well as an admin, this is at an admin level that you would turn these on, you'll see schedule underneath more. So if you are scheduling out employees, you can get to it here, where you can select a date range, select an employee, and view what they're scheduled for. And of course, down below, we do have the launch into browser option here, and help, so that you can get help. And then over here at the top, under more, we have these gear icons. If I click the gear icons, I'm actually gonna get some drop-down options. And this is gonna allow me to control the setup or eliminate things that no longer need to be here. So inside here, I'll be able to make adjustments. For example, if I click employees inside here, I can actually navigate between who's active and who's currently inactive. I can click to more details about my already added employees. I can see all of their information. I could deactivate an employee from here. Same with managers and admins, we could come in and remove if we needed to. And same with departments and jobs. If we launched this in here, we would see more information about this and be able to delete or remove something. So this is just where we control what's available to be seen. And that is how you use the app from that admin manager perspective. We hope that this was helpful. If you have any questions, you can reach out to support@ontheclock.com. You can live chat with us, or you can call us as well. If you liked this content that you see here, go ahead and like, share, and subscribe. And we look forward to seeing you again.